In this lecture, we are going to discuss about range straggling and energy straggling. Now, if you have identical particles which are traveling in a medium, so let's say all these particles, they have same amount of energy. So let's say all these particles, they have 1 MeV of energy. Now you will have large number of particles. Here I have shown only 3 particles, but there will be large number of particles which will be traveling in this material. So let's suppose they all have same amount of energy. Now you will be thinking that if the particles are same and they have same energy, means they have same velocities, then their range must be the same inside the same absorbing material. Now, what is the range? We have discussed that range is the distance which is traveled by a particle before losing all of its energy inside the material. As the particle will travel in the medium, it will lose its energy, and the distance which it travels inside the medium before losing all of its energy, that distance is called as the range of the particle in that particular material. Now, if you have identical particles which have same amount of initial energy, that is before entering the medium, they have same amount of energy, then you will be thinking that all these particles must have same range inside the same absorbing medium, because particles are the same, energy is the same, medium is the same, therefore they must have the same range in this absorbing medium. But this does not happen. And this does not happen due to some fluctuations that we are going to see. So it has been found that even if the identical charged particles, we have identical charged particles, possess same initial kinetic energy. So identical charged particles which are having same initial kinetic energy do not have same range in the same absorbing medium. So identical particles with same initial kinetic energy do not have same range in the absorbing medium. This variation in ranges of the particles is called as range straggling. So this phenomena that all the particles will not have same range, will not have a constant range, this phenomena is called as range straggling. So let's say this first particle, when it is traveling with 1 MeV of energy, let's say it travels a distance of 10 centimeters inside this medium before its energy goes to zero. So this first particle, it reaches at this point and loses, up to this point it has lost all of its energy. So up to 10 centimeter, let's suppose that 10 centimeter is the distance in which the first particle loses all of its energy. So these are just examples that I am giving. So in exam, you do not have to write these numbers like 10 centimeter or 1 MeV. So this is just for your understanding that what is range straggling. Now let's suppose the first particle has traveled 10 centimeter inside the material before losing all of its energy. And the second particle, let's say it travels a distance of 10.1 centimeter. So range of the first particle is 10 centimeter, range of second particle is 10.1 centimeter. And this third particle, let's say it travels a distance of 9.9 centimeters. So first particle has a range of 10 centimeters, second has a range of 10.1 centimeters, third has a range of 9.9 centimeters, and there are large number of particles. Here I have shown only 3 particles, but there are large number of particles, so the range of all these particles will be different, but they will all be averaged around one single value. When you will take the average, they will all be averaged around a single value. Now there is always a distribution of ranges. So there is a distribution of ranges. The first particle is having 10 centimeter of range, second is having 10.1, third is having 9.9, fourth will be having 10.2, or it will be having 8 centimeter, but it will all these ranges, they will be averaged around some particular value, and that is called as mean range. So when you will take average of all these values, you will get certain value, and that will be called as the mean range. Now, why does this happen? As we have identical particles with same amount of energy and we have the same absorbing medium, so now why do these particles, they have distribution in ranges? So the reason is that the loss of energy, the process by which these charged particles lose energy in the absorbing medium, is completely a statistical process. So we cannot predict that by what amount the particle will lose energy in a single collision, or what are the total number of collisions that a particle faces during its path. So there are basically two reasons that why do we have distribution of ranges. First is that there is fluctuation in energy lost by the ion in each collision. So let's say the first particle in one collision loses E1 amount of energy, then in second collision the same particle is losing E2 amount of energy, then in third collision with the nucleus of the absorbing medium, it will lose energy, as we already discussed, that these heavy charged particles, they lose energy by ionizations and by making ionizations and excitations in the atom. So they will lose their energy due to the, they will lose their energy to the orbital electrons. They will give their energy to the orbital electrons of the absorbing medium. So in one collision, let's say it loses E1 amount of energy, then in second collision, the same charged particle is losing E2 amount of energy. So this loss of energy is not constant in every collision. So there is a fluctuation in energy lost by the ion in each collision, as well as there is fluctuation in number of collisions in unit path length. So if you take a unit path length, let's say if you take 1 centimeter of length, then in that 1 centimeter of length, the number of collisions, they keep on changing. So let's say if you take 1 centimeter over here and you take 1 centimeter over here, then in this first 1 centimeter of length, the first particle, it will have different number of collisions as compared to the another 1 centimeter length. So let's say in this first unit path length, in this first unit path length, the first particle, let's say it has 1000 collisions, it is facing 1000 collisions in this path length, then in second path length the number of collisions might be 1100. So the number of collisions in unit path length keep on changing, so there is a fluctuation. So you cannot say that number of collisions will remain the same in unit path length. So you cannot say that number of collisions are same, and you also cannot say that the energy lost in each collisions remains the same. So there is a fluctuation in energy lost in each collision, as well as there is a fluctuation in number of collisions per unit path length. Then we have the second reason that why there is distribution of ranges. So second reason is that the absorbing medium may have non-uniform density. So this absorbing medium may have non-uniform density, therefore different particles may cover different paths. So due to the non-uniform density, the different particles will have different ranges. So there are fluctuations in the path length for fixed loss in energy. So let's say at this point, before entering the medium, the energy of the particle is E, and at this point its energy is zero. Similarly, the second particle has energy E over here, and at this point it loses all of its energy, so its energy is zero. Similar is the case for third particle, energy is E over here, and up to this length it loses whole of its energy, so its energy is zero. So for fixed loss of energy, so energy is going from E to 0, from E to 0, from E to 0. So for fixed loss of energy, the path length, or you can say the range, is changing. So there is a fluctuation in the range of the particles, and reasons I have given over here. So ideally, what must be the graph of transmission versus the thickness, the length which is traveled in the medium? So x is the penetration depth, or you can say it is the absorber thickness. So you can say that this is the penetration depth, the distance which it has traveled in the medium. Then t is the transmission coefficient. So 1 represents that all the particles are transmitted, and 0 represents that all the particles, that there is no particle. So 0 transmission means that there is no particle transmitted, and 1 transmission is equal to 1 means that all the particles are transmitted. So the first graph, as you can see, that as you are changing the penetration depth, at all these penetration depths inside the medium, the transmission coefficient is equal to 1. Means all the particles are transmitted. So let's say if you are taking at this point, at this penetration depth, all these particles will be transmitted. So T will be equal to 1 in that case. So up to this penetration depth, let's say up to this point, all the particles are transmitted. So transmission will be equal to 1. And similar is the case for this length, for this amount of length in the medium. So all the particles are transmitted. And ideally, what must be the case, that up to this much amount of distance, all the particles are transmitted, but after this much amount of distance in the medium, no particle is transmitted. So this is the ideal case. So this must happen. So ideally, this must happen, that all the particles have same range. So this is the ideal case. So up to this length, all the particles were present, but after this length in the medium, there is no particle. The transmission goes to 0. So there is no particle means all the particles are having same range. But this is not the case that happens practically. So practically what happens, that all the particles, they have different ranges. Up to this point, they are having transmission equal to 1. Up to this point also, they will have transmission equal to 1. But things will change when the penetration depth is close to this point. So some of the particles will be stopped over here, and some particles are still transmitted through this length. So up to this length, so when the transmission depth is equal to this point, at this point, some of the particles are stopped, you can see, but some of the particles are still transmitted. So the transmission coefficient will start decreasing after a certain amount of length. And you can see over here that as the penetration depth is increasing, firstly, the transmission coefficient is equal to 1, means all the particles are, they are transmitted. All the particles are transmitted over here up to this length. But after certain amount of length in the medium, the transmission starts decreasing. So the transmission curve remains constant up to some distance, but after that it starts to fall gradually. So it starts to fall gradually, which indicates that the particles are now being stopped. So the transmission starts dropping, the transmission curve starts dropping over here, means that now some of the particles are being stopped and some of the particles are still transmitted. And up to this point, no particle will be transmitted further. So all the particles will be stopped over here. Now at this point, the transmission is equal to 0.5. Means half of the particles are transmitted and half of the particles have been stopped up to this point. So at this transmission of 0.5, means half, when the transmission is equal to half, at this point, if you find the distance in the medium, so the distance or the range at which the number of transmitted particles becomes equal to half, the number of transmitted particles becomes equal to half, and the number of particles that have been stopped That is also half. So half of the particles are stopped and half of the particles are still transmitted when t is equal to 0.5. So at this point, when t is equal to 0.5, the range that we get, this is the mean range. So this is the mean range, and it can be represented by Rm. And then at this point, if you draw a tangent, so this is a curve. So actually this is a curve. So at this point, if you draw a tangent and you extrapolate it, then this will cut the x-axis at this point, and this is called as the extrapolated range. So this is the value of the thickness which is obtained by extrapolating the linear portion. So this is the extrapolated range represented by REX. So this is the extrapolated range represented by REX. And the difference between REX and RM, the difference between REX and RM is given by degree of straggling SR. So the difference of REX and the mean range represents the degree of straggling. Now we are going to talk about energy straggling. So we just talked about the range straggling. So range straggling happens when the energy of the particle becomes equal to zero and we are finding the distance which it has traveled. So the distance which the particles travel by losing same amount of energy is not the same, and that is what we call as the range straggling. But in the case of energy straggling, we will be taking the same amount of path length. So we will be taking same amount of path length and we will be looking at the energy of each particle by traveling that path length. So in this, we observe the fluctuations in the energy of the particles for fixed path length. So we fix the path length in this case and we find out what are the energies of the particles. So ideally, if you have identical charged particles with same amount of energy, then if you look at the same penetration depth in the absorbing medium, so all these particles, they must attain same amount of energy after traveling same amount of path length in this absorbing medium. So ideally, this must be the case. So these are the charged particles with same amount of energy and they are traveling in this same medium. So when they will travel in this medium, they will be losing their energy. And ideally, after a certain amount of distance, all these particles must attain same amount of energy. But this does not happen in real case. So there is a fluctuation in the energy. So if you look at these particles after they travel same amount of distance in the absorbing medium, so the energy of these particles fluctuate. So there is a distribution in energy. So ideally all these particles must have same amount of energy, but in actual there is a distribution or fluctuation in the energy of the particles for fixed path length. And this is called as energy straggling. Now dE by dx, this is the mean energy loss. So dE by dx, which we calculated in the Bethe-Block formula, this is the mean energy loss. But if we talk about a single particle, the amount of energy loss will not be equal to this mean value. So this is just the average. So this dE by dx, which we calculate in Bethe-Block formula, this is just the average. But for a single charged particle, the amount of energy loss will not be exactly equal to this mean value. So it will be around this mean value, but it will not be exactly. So all these particles, they will have they will lose their energy, but they will not lose exactly equal to dE by dx, because this is the mean energy loss. So a monochromatic beam of monoenergetic beam of charged particles after passing through a fixed thickness inside the absorbing medium, shows a distribution of energy around some mean value. So let's say if there is 1 mega electron volt energy of all these particles, then after traveling same amount of thickness, let's say the first particle has left with just 5 mega electron volt of energy. Second particle is left with 4.9 mega electron volt of energy. It will be 0.5. Or you can say, instead of this, let's say you have 10 mega electron volt energy of each particle. So the first particle is left with just 5 mega electron volt energy. Earlier it had 10 mega electron volt. Now it has 5 mega electron volt after traveling this much thickness. Then the second particle is left with 4.9. Then this third particle is left with 5.1. So as you can see that this value is around some mean value. So there is a distribution of energy around some mean value, and this is called as energy straggling. So a monoenergetic beam of charged particles after passing through fixed thickness in the absorbing medium shows a distribution of energy around some mean value, and this is called as energy straggling. And this energy straggling is also due to the same reasons that we did in the case of range straggling. So the reasons are the same. First is that there are fluctuations in the energy loss in each collision. So every single particle loses different amount of energy in each collision. Second is that there is a fluctuation in the number of collisions which are faced by a particle in traveling this much thickness. So there is a fluctuation. So there is a fluctuation in the number of collisions in unit path length. So due to these fluctuations, there is a fluctuation in the energy for fixed path length, and that is called as energy straggling.